Then the men were exceedingly afraid, and said to him, Why have you done this? For the men knew that he fled from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them. Then they said to him, What shall we do to you that the sea may be calm for us? For the sea was growing more tempestuous. And he said to them, Pick me up and throw me into the sea. Then the sea will become calm for you. For I know that this great tempest is because of me. Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to return to land, but they could not, for the sea continued to grow more tempestuous against them. Therefore they cried out to the Lord and said, We pray, O Lord, please do not let us perish for this man's life, and do not charge us with innocent blood. For you, O Lord, have done as it pleased you. So they picked up Jonah and threw him into the sea, and the sea ceased from its raging. Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly, and offered a sacrifice to the Lord, and took vows. Now Jonah and some sailors are in the middle of a dangerous storm sent by God. Jonah had fled after God commanded him to go to Nineveh, and the sailors were exceedingly afraid. Fear comes when we realize that we do not have control. The sailors knew that God was in control, and they feared God's judgment upon Jonah. The fear of God's judgment, the fear of hell, has brought many people to God. The sailors' eyes were being opened to the one true God. But what about Jonah? Did he fear God's judgment? Like a loving parent, God was not just trying to punish Jonah, but to correct him. We have had human fathers who corrected us, and we paid them respect. Shall we not much more readily be in subjection to the Father of spirits and live? Jonah was not paying God respect. When the sailors were confronted with judgment, they wanted answers. Even in his disobedience, the sailors went to the believer, Jonah, for answers, because the answer is found with God. Jesus is the answer to all our problems. Sin has destroyed our lives, and Jesus came and died for our sins. When people in our lives face judgment, they will also want answers. If somebody came to you, would you be able to explain to them how to be saved? Would you tell them just to live good lives? Would you tell them just to go to church? Or would you tell them that they are separated from God because of sin? That Jesus, God the Son in the flesh, came to earth to save us from our sins? That he died on the cross for our sins and came back to life? That they need to repent, turn away from their sins? And that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved? We do not know everything that Jonah told the sailors about God, but we do know that Jonah did not tell them to turn the ship around. He said to them, Pick me up and throw me into the sea. Then the sea will become calm for you, for I know that this great tempest is because of me. Jonah would rather die than turn around and go to Nineveh. Jonah was willing to sacrifice himself for the sailors. When you go through suffering with other people, it can give you a different perspective. It can allow you to empathize with others when you walk in their shoes. Jonah's possible concern for the sailors did not make much sense. Like the people of Nineveh, the pagan sailors worshiped false gods. Jonah might not have really cared about the sailors. He could have been in despair due to his disobedience. Is this where you are in your life? Are you in despair due to your bad choices? Are you disobeying God? Do you feel hopeless? Our emotions can deceive us into believing there is no hope in God. God's Word, the Bible, gives us clarity to avoid being deceived by our emotions. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. For doctrine, teaching us who God is, who we are, and how to be saved. For reproof, to let us know when we are sinning, falling short of God's glory. For correction, to tell us how to get back to living for God. For instruction in righteousness, to instruct us how to live for God before we go down the wrong path, that we may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. Jonah told the sailors to throw him in the sea, but nevertheless the men rowed hard to return to land. Nevertheless, the pagan sailors cared more about Jonah, one man, than Jonah cared for the tens of thousands of people in Nineveh. We should be ashamed when the lost world shows more concern for people than Christians do. Do you have a cold heart of indifference toward the suffering of other people? Do you say they got what they deserve when a criminal dies? What is God's opinion about people? people that are made in the image of God, people that need God's mercy just as much as you. The Pharisees and scribes complained about Jesus, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." So he spoke this parable to them, saying, "What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost.' I say to you that likewise there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 just persons who need no repentance." Jesus cares about the lost sheep. He came to save sinners. That is you. That is me. God cared for Jonah, the sailors, and the people of Nineveh. Jonah did not seem to care. But this storm appears to have brought the pagan sailors to the one true God. Therefore they cried out to the Lord and said, "We pray, O Lord, please do not let us perish for this man's life, and do not charge us with innocent blood, for you, O Lord, have done as it pleased you." Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly and offered a sacrifice to the Lord and took vows. The sailors feared God, and they did not want to be held guilty for Jonah's death. And they prayed for God's mercy. They threw Jonah off the boat, and the Lord, the God of heaven, who made the sea and the dry land, stopped the storm. Do you realize that one bad person like Jonah, one bad influence, can be the cause of storms in your life? The solution is probably not to throw them off of a ship, but you should pray for God's guidance. Who are you allowing in your life? Then the men were exceedingly afraid and said to him, "Why have you done this?" For the men knew that he fled from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them. Then they said to him, "What shall we do to you that the sea may be calm for us?" For the sea was growing more tempestuous. And he said to them, "Pick me up and throw me into the sea. Then the sea will become calm for you. For I know that this great tempest is because of me." Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to return to land, but they could not, for the sea continued to grow more tempestuous against them. Therefore they cried out to the Lord and said, "We pray, O Lord, please do not let us perish for this man's life, and do not charge us with innocent blood, for you, O Lord, have done as it pleased you." So they picked up Jonah and threw him into the sea, and the sea ceased from its raging. Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly, and offered a sacrifice to the Lord, and took vows. The sailors saw God's power and responded to him. They offered a sacrifice to God and took vows. And now the storm is stopped, because Jonah has been thrown into the water. In the next video, we will find out what happens as Jonah sinks into the sea.